Mitosis.
I'm William Feist, and today I'm presenting to you my project that I like to call Cell Check. I find that biology is really complicated, and sometimes someone needs to make sure that your cells are behaving. So when someone has a heart attack, they're left with damaged heart tissue. Your body and your doctor do what they can to repair this, but they can only do so much, leaving you with a damaged heart. A lot of current therapies are working to use stem cells, a base type of cell that can become any other cell, to insert them into the heart so that they can, ideally, become new heart cells that repair and replace the damaged tissue. Sounds pretty great, right? Well, there's just one small problem. Without being able to image through deep tissue, it's really difficult to tell if these cells are actually becoming heart cells. Biology is complicated. And for all we know, these cells could be becoming liver cells or kidney cells, just something you really don't want. This is where my work comes in. I've been working in the Warmflash lab here at Rice to develop a way to mark and track these stem cell treatments so you know what type of cell they're becoming. I'm able to mark the genes for becoming a heart cell or a liver cell or a kidney cell and then detect that in the blood to know what your cells are doing. And it's pretty simple. No expensive scans or difficult surgeries, just a simple blood test to detect it. To do this, I use a new cool technology called CRISPR-Cas, which is used by scientists now to edit genes much easier and more efficiently than we've ever been able to do before. What I use it for is to take a target gene and add a marker to it, so that every time this gene is made, my marker is made as well. So what CRISPR-Cas does is it finds this gene, moves to it, adds my marker, and then leaves, essentially flagging the gene. So when you have your engineered cell, every time that gene is made, the flag is made as well. This flag can then leave the cell, travel through the blood, and is detected through a simple test. And the neat thing is, by changing the flag slightly, I can change what signal is detected, letting me mark as many genes as I want. This way, I can mark heart genes, I can mark liver genes, and I can mark kidney genes. And I can do this all in the same cell, so that one cell can tell me exactly what it's becoming. This way, when you put cells in the body, they go and find their final destination, and they become, whether they're becoming a liver or a heart or a kidney, they'll produce the marker associated with that organ, telling your doctor exactly what those cells are becoming. So, when you use a stem cell treatment to treat a patient's damaged heart, the cells will travel to the heart and begin producing the marker. Heart marker, liver marker, kidney marker, and your doctor can detect this with a simple blood test. And this way, if anything goes wrong, your doctor can act before you have a second liver. Thank you.